Hello, my name is Dr. Paul Mason, and today I'd like to talk to you about the moon, and specifically the rotation of the moon and the orbit of the moon around the Earth. Now, if we consider the Earth here, and I'll remind you of the tilt of the Earth, 23 and a half degrees, with respect to how it orbits around the sun. The moon orbits with the Earth around the sun, taking 365 and a quarter days to do that each time. But in addition to going around the sun, the moon orbits the Earth. It does so in the same direction that it goes around the sun. So if we talk about the spin of the Earth going this way, the orbit of the Earth moving this way around, and it always has to point in the same direction. So let me begin again. The Earth is spinning once every 23 hours, 56 minutes, orbiting the sun. You can imagine the sun here in the center, always pointing toward Polaris, the North Star, taking 365 and a quarter days to do so. So bringing the moon in, if I show you what the moon looks like in just kind of a pictorial way here, some features on the moon, and if I turn it, spin this way, you can see and notice the spin of the moon by seeing the features on it. But many people know that when you look at the moon, you always see the same side. You always see the same face. Sometimes called the man on the moon, or the face on the moon, or other kinds of features that are well known. In fact, we never see the so-called backside of the moon. So I've depicted that here on this model of the moon. One thing that's not to scale, the moon is actually only 1/4 of the diameter of the Earth. So it would have to be a little bit smaller, but it's pretty near the right size, and what we want to describe here can be done pretty well with this, and that is we want to see that from Earth, as the moon orbits Earth, it always appears from the same side. We always see this face here. I'll show the camera, but now showing Earth, we always see that same face. But as the moon orbits the Earth is spinning very fast, once every 23 hours, 56 minutes, but the moon is also spinning, taking 27 and a third days to spin. And since that time to spin is the same as the time to orbit the Earth, the same side of the moon always faces the Earth. And this is not an accident, because somehow the dynamics of the moon and how the moon is spinning and the Earth is spinning caused the moon to slant in this direction and just always spin and orbit at the same time period. So it's not a coincidence. It has to do with the dynamics of the gravity of between the moon and the Earth. But we got to keep in mind then that I'll do this, look at this carefully one time here. We could begin back here, and you notice that from your point of view, somewhere else, like say Mars or Venus, somewhere else in the solar system, the moon does look like it's spinning very slowly. But from the point of view on Earth, we notice that we're always seeing the same face of the moon. So it's important to keep in mind that these two times are not exactly a month. They're 27 and a third days, and it is two times. The spin of the moon, rotation, how long it takes to spin around, is 27 and a third days, and how long it takes to orbit the Earth is also 27 and a third days. So let's consider what we would see if we were on the moon. First of all, since the moon is spinning, if you were located at any place on the moon, you would see different stars at different times because of the spinning of the moon. And it's just like on Earth, except that the process is much slower on the moon. It would take 2 weeks for a star to rise up and cross the sky and set. It would also take about 2 weeks for the sun to rise, cross the sky, and set, because the moon is rotating much slower than the Earth rotates. Remember, once every day, approximately, 23 hours, 56 minutes for the Earth to spin, 27 and a third days, that's 27 times longer for the moon to spin one time. So you would notice that in terms of the stars moving across the sky and the sun moving across the sky. And because of the locking between the rotation of the Earth, the rotation of the moon and the orbit of the moon, only certain places on the moon would ever see Earth. You would have to be on one side of the moon to ever see anything on the Earth. And if you were on the other side of the moon, the Earth would never be in view, because as we look at one more time, watch the moon, the Earth would be spinning very fast here. I won't do that part. We'll have the moon go around, and this back area here that you see now, the backside of the moon, areas there, a person located over there, an astronaut say, would not see the Earth at all, ever. Whereas around on the other side here, over here, people on the moon would be able to see the Earth all the time. All right. So let me just conclude with several times that we now have with three bodies involved. We have the time it takes for the Earth to spin once, that's 23 hours, 56 minutes. The time it takes for the sun to appear to go around the sky once, that's exactly 24 hours. The time it takes for the moon to spin once, 27 and a third days. The time it takes the moon to orbit once, also 27 and a third days. And then how long it takes the moon to go through its phases. Those are the phases like full moon and quarter moon that take a little bit longer, 29 and a half days, because that involves three objects: the source of light, the sun, the moon, the object being illuminated, and the Earth, us looking at the moon and seeing what kind of phase it looks like. And so that length of time takes 29 and a half days, and that's where we get our month from. That's it.